Hi guys, my name is Anujindal. Welcome to Morning Tales for August 2nd, 2019. So, it's almost 6 o'clock in the morning and I'm making this video. What we're going to do today is we're going to again discuss some factual questions or static questions, and we are also going to discuss a lot of current affairs questions. I'm also going to give you a small homework based on one question, and you just have to mention whatever you can remember or recall with respect to what I'm going to ask. So stick around, watch the entire video, complete the listen, and you will have something more to learn today. Okay. The first question is, what is the new strength of judges in the Supreme Court as approved by Union Cabinet? Union Cabinet has been approving increasing the strength of Supreme Court judges continuously or consistently for quite some time. In 2009 also, it was increased to the present strength of 31, and now it has been increased to 34, including the Chief Justice of India. So remember this, because a lot of news items are showing that it has been increased to 33. Well, yes, it has been increased to 33, but that excludes the CJI. Okay. And the last time it was done was in the year 2009, when it was increased to 31. So this is something that you can remember, and you would know by this that it's not the first time that something like this is happening. Now, which article of the Constitution of India considers or talks about the strength of Supreme Court judges? It is Article 124. Article 124(1). So, this is the one which talks about strength of Supreme Court judges, and therefore it requires a parliamentary amendment or parliamentary change in the legislation in order to make it effective. Second question, who among the following has become the first wing commander of Indian Air Force to perform wingsuit skydive jump? So this is how a wingsuit skydive jump looks like. A very factual and a simple question, but these kind of questions are asked in the examination. So through this, you would know that, okay, these are the kinds of questions that can be asked in the examination as well. The answer to this question is E, Arun Chaudhary. Third question is, with which institute has Tata Medical Center partnered to set a first of its kind comprehensive digital archive of cancer imaging? The purpose of this digital archive of cancer imaging is to create an archive of cancer patients, an archive of cancer cases, an archive of anomalies happening in cancer issues in order to carry out successful and long-term research, so that the ultimate objective of finding a solution to cancer can be achieved. The answer is IIT Kharagpur. IIT Kharagpur and Tata Medical Center have come together. Where is ISRO going to set up its ISRO Technical Liaison Unit? I think with the picture only, you can easily understand with which country have we done this. The answer is Russia. The purpose is to work more on space technology, and Russia has actually fallen behind in space technology after the end of Cold War period, and I believe India and Russia are trying to come together on this and recreate the hegemony or the dominance that Russia had, and at the same time India wants to contribute towards that, because now India has been doing well in space technology very much. So it's a good initiative. I believe it can be very fruitful, because both the parties here have good intentions of coming together. Innovation for Clean Air is a joint initiative between India and DASH for 2 years to test interventions related to air quality and e-vehicle integration. So this has happened between India and UK. An Innovation for Clean Air initiative for 2 years has been set up, under which India and UK will try and come together and determine how to push e-vehicle integration in India. Okay, the purpose is more on electronic vehicles. How much FDI inflow did India receive during 2018-19 according to Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade? 64.37 billion, highest till now. That is the amount of FDI inflow that India has received recently. Now, the homework that you have is related to question 5. Let's come back to it. We were talking about e-vehicle integration. So, you are supposed to tell me what is the name of that scheme which has been launched for e-vehicle, for promotion and expansion of e-vehicles in the country, and what are the provisions of that scheme. We discussed that very recently, I believe 2 to 3 days back. We had a session on government schemes wherein I revised about 26 of government schemes, and in that I talked about this scheme as well. So you're expected to tell me about the provisions of that scheme and the name of that scheme. Going to be very important for both phase 1 and phase 2 of upcoming RBI and SEBI examinations. Okay. Let's now come back. We're done with the sixth question. Sixth question, in fact, is very important. Why? Because the first time that we've crossed this mark, and FDI inflow data of every year is often asked in the examination. Who has become the first cricketer in the world to score 1000 runs and take 100 wickets in T20 format? You might be thinking that scoring 1000 runs is not difficult. Well, yes, scoring 1000 runs is not difficult, but doing both these things, 1000 runs plus 100 wickets, nobody has done it. Shahid Afridi is the closest with I think approximately 1400 runs but 98 wickets. So even he has not been able to cross this mark. Okay. The answer is Ellis Perry, who is an Australian cricketer, and she's the first one to do this. Which city has topped the Quaccarelli Simon's best student cities ranking? The purpose of this ranking is to find out cities where student facilities are the maximum, where students find it easiest to live. They have all the facilities possible for public transport, for let's say libraries and all those things. Okay, so according to this, London is the best city when it comes to friendliness towards students, and the best among India from India is Bengaluru. Bengaluru is the best city from India as per this ranking. Okay, the next one is, who is the Director General of WIPO? Director General of WIPO. The purpose of WIPO and when was WIPO set up? Please tell me that. Is it a UN specialized agency? Yes or no? And where are the headquarters? Let me tell you the headquarters, and you have to tell me the purpose of WIPO and when was it set up. The headquarters are in Geneva, Switzerland, and the present Director General of WIPO is Francis Gurry. So Francis Gurry is the Director General, and headquarters are in Geneva, Switzerland. And now you have to tell me all the other things that I asked. Okay. Headquarters of International Standards Organization. Again, is it a UN agency? Yes or no? Okay. Please mention it in the comment section below by writing WIPO, UN agency, yes or no? ISO, UN agency, yes or no? Okay. When was it set up? It was set up in 1947. And where are the headquarters located? Geneva, Switzerland. So headquarters of both ISO and WIPO are in Geneva. Now the good thing about this is that you can actually submit all the answers and you can get your score live along with explanations if any are available in that particular day. Although I'm making these videos in order to explain all those things to you. So what you have to do is you just have to submit with these details, and you will get instant response on the same page with respect to how you have performed, what are the things that you've done right, what are the answers that you got wrong. So this kind of live feedback helps students a lot. Okay, so do it on a regular basis. It's certainly going to help you a lot. We're doing it for phase 1 as well as phase 2 RBI and SEBI examination. Okay, so that was all for today's morning tales. I hope you liked it. Have a nice day. Do subscribe to the channel if you like this video, if you learn something new, and do answer my questions in the comment section below. I want you guys to be telling me all these questions and all these homeworks that I've given to you. Okay, take care. We'll meet tomorrow again. All the very best.